services and orange business services. First of all, I would like to thank the board for their trust, appointing me this summer as advisory board director. It's not just only a great personal honor, but above all, it's a strong opportunity for orange business services to be part of the development of the industry, the entire industry. The industry is surrounded by SDX technology, giving access to a relatively new, orchestrated, and API world. Today, I see it as a Christmas present. Before Christmas, being able, having been asked to share with you some insight on what we define as intelligent business driver connectivity. Showing how we are transforming our infrastructure, connectivity infrastructure and services to support our customers in their high-speed race toward digital transformation. To set the scene, I propose to have a look at three key megatrends that provide currently strong opportunity to all actors in the entire industry. First one is IoT, with its exponential growth, creating an urgent need for network segmentation and a large wireless coverage, with Wi-Fi 6 and 5G arriving, and also a real and consistent continuity between the LAN and the WAN. Second one is real time, where we see a merge between computing performance and SDX, meaning LAN and WAN technology. And the last one, not surprisingly, is artificial intelligence, where the combination of real time and artificial intelligence will enable us continuously and increasingly improve business performances. So these three trends have influenced our vision towards a flexible and intelligent business driver network for our customers. Being able to provide to our customers more agility to simplify and accelerate deployment with co-management capabilities, reduce risk with more automation, and end-to-end performance from the edge to the cloud. This vision shows that the borders between WLAN, LAN, WAN, and cloud connectivity are disappearing. How come? Networks have finally become a key IT asset based on virtualization and automation. And it's now part of the entire value chain, including the LAN. So thanks to SDX technology, we are now able to monitor from end-to-end workflow to ensure segmentation continuity from the edge to the application, wherever they are located, and finally to bring to our customers a real game changer in their multi-cloud strategy with our connectivity solution. And on that matter, what we have observed since last year is the strong acceleration of customers who wanted to move their application to a multi-cloud model. Today, we support this multi-cloud model by delivering end-to-end solutions with our flexible offer. The brain behind all this is our next-gen app. In a nutshell, next-gen app combines strong network capabilities, internet peering, MPLS backbone, cloud connectivity, with virtualization capability, and all this is fully managed by our global orchestration. But in the network, footprint is key in order to be able to achieve end user experience and application performance. That's the reason why we are deploying our next-gen hubs at all major cloud service provider locations to deliver direct cloud connectivity to more than 40 cloud service providers, including Microsoft, of course. But next-gen hub, as mentioned already, allows as well to deliver virtualized services to ensure security and optimize connectivity to the cloud. The beauty of all this is that global orchestration is able to manage both services consistently at branch office with the cloud interconnection. That's exactly what we have provided to a global maritime company. This customer wanted to optimize his multi-cloud strategy to improve the agility of his IT infrastructure with a very strong demand, a very strong requirement for security. So we start to provide a solution based on our next-gen hub, of course, to connect this customer to the two cloud service providers selected by him. What we guarantee with our next-gen hub is to smoothly add other cloud service providers with the same architecture and to easily optimize or change his multi-cloud strategy by moving flows from one cloud service provider to another. For this customer, we also secure all the flow from the next-gen hub to the cloud service provider, ensuring a consistent security policy among cloud service providers. The outcome is a fully secure multi-cloud connectivity solution and infrastructure able to deliver strong performance and agility and compatible with the strong requirement of security of this customer. But it's only the top of the iceberg. Let's go beyond infrastructure. Because at the end of the day, what really matters is end-user satisfaction. That's the reason why we are heavily invested in global monitoring to accompany this global IT transformation. Our global monitoring has three levels of components. The first one is the global environment, addressing the global infrastructure from the customer side to internet and cloud performance. And we are doing that with the announcement that we have done today with our partnership with PowerDynax. The second one is customer usage. In order to monitor real-time performance of SD-WAN tunneling, we have natively integrated live action solution in our flexible SD-WAN portal. Last but not least, end user, that will be the first one to complain if any performance issue occurs. We address and we manage the end user's perception of cloud and SD-WAN transformation thanks to our visibility as a service that we are doing with Google. This global approach of global monitoring ensures to fulfill the strong requirement of our customers for end-user satisfaction. For example, we have done that for a global leading company that wanted to make sure and to find the best way to connect this Chinese site, it's not so easy for me to say, to Azure and Office 365. To do so, we have done a full assessment, measuring and comparing customers' architecture with direct connectivity to internet to the cloud, with MPLS connectivity to our next-gen hub directly connected to Azure and Office 365. I am sorry, Ross. At the end of the day, the second solution has shown 4 times better performance. So this highlights that global monitoring is very important to highlight strong performance from the architecture for our flexible SD-WAN solution. Our flexible SD-WAN solution has been designed to facilitate our customers' network transformation and is based on 5 pillars. Native cloud connectivity, of course, being one of them, for which we count on MailVox for standardization. Let's take SD-WAN expertise, for which we are continuously improving. And the last announcement has been done this Monday by the addition of a new technology member, Fortinet, in addition to Cisco SD-WAN and Cisco Verity. Let's see how MEV developments are providing value to flexible SD-WAN, to these pillars, and to the others. SD-WAN service distribution and attributes. SD-WAN data model. orchestration and MSO API will allow us to simplify all this for our customers from service definition to integration using our technology agnostic portal. Let's go to global services. Global services is our operational model and our ability to deliver underlay and overlay in 220 countries with more than 500 carrier partners delivering internet or ethernet. This has been simplified over the last years by carrier ethernet standardization and certification, and will be improved thanks to carrier ethernet 3.0, orchestration model, and API model on top of this LSO data that we intend to use. I can do the same for security and future-proof. But as all service providers in this room, we need to continue to support MEP in this development in order to make sure that along the way, we will be able to continue to ease digital transformation for our customers. And as example for digital transformation, let's take Sony. Sony wanted to move a major part of its IT to the cloud, but with a very huge impact on its network infrastructure. To achieve this goal, they entrusted us to gather all their existing contracts with their service provider and then to manage the transformation into an harmonized and network-proof configuration network. Based on our flexible SD-WAN solution, we have used our multi-sourcing service integration to first take the management of all the network and ease the transformation to a full underlay and overlay flexible SD-WAN solution. The new Sony networks provides improved performance, security, and scalability to their operation. But back to the vision. End user experience is starting from the edge, where we see a strong evolution of LAN and WLAN becoming key assets and strategic assets. In order to achieve this end user experience across the increasing multiplicity of usage in the local area network, from traditional IT application to real-time IoT traffic, SDX, SD-LAN solution are able to provide strong Wi-Fi coverage and advanced monitoring and analytics to anticipate. To make that concrete, let's take this example of a customer acting in health, nutrition, and sustainable living. The end user experience under the WLAN coverage was declining. So they have decided to change and to define a new LAN strategy to build an agile infrastructure able to provide better user experience to their 25,000 employees. Before this project, the LAN was managed as a commodity on the local responsibility in the 45 countries. So we have delivered our SD-LAN offering with the key following outputs. Risk reduction thanks to a new security policy access and micro-segmentation. A central orchestration for a strong, agile way of configure the network. And last but not least, enhanced user experience thanks to advanced analytics tools. But I think it's time to end up this presentation with few key takeaways. We are used to say, or to hear, that cloud is eating the world. Really? I don't know. But what I can see is that multi-cloud strategy is driving the world. And end-user experience is the hottest topic for businesses. And it's no longer just a question of owning infrastructure. We need to be able to monitor globally this solution. Despite some actors, we are seeing that underlay doesn't matter. Underlay and overlay are more than ever linked, with underlay which has already dramatically emerge. We are living in a borderless world from edge to the clouds, and even if it will take time, we need to figure out it as a new paradigm. And it is important and urgent to understand that everything is starting from SDR or SD branch, whatever you may do it. Last but not least, very important, in order to move forward successfully in this SDX world, math developments are key for us. Thank you for your attention.